गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, जस्ट होल्ड ऑन ए सेकेंड, आई विल बी बैक जस्ट टू मिनट्स। गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो, गुड इवनिंग,
गुड इवनिंग
गाइस, विल एबल टू हियर?
गुड इवनिंग सर।
यस सर।
सो व्हाट वी आर डिस्कसिंग गाइस, वी आर डिस्कसिंग, एनीवन कैन गिव व्हाट वी आर डिस्कसिंग इन लास्ट सेशन? Students, please. What you are discussing in last session? Students, please. We completed 8th theorem. SAS criterion completed.
Sir, we completed SSS criterion of similarity, sir.
Yeah, SSS, but we have to start SAS criterion, correct? The next one is side angle side criterion. SAS criterion. So, if I know two sides, suppose if I am having a triangle ABC, these two sides are 3 cm and 4 cm and this angle is 60 degrees. So the angle between the 3 cm side, 4 cm side, so side and their side, the angle formed by these two. So side angle side. I am taking the another triangle with this 4.5 cm, which is exactly 1.5 times 6 cm. 1.5 into 4 is, and this is angle is 60 degrees. This is PQR. Two sides are in the same ratio and the angle formed by the two sides is same, then I can say both are similar. This is what SAS criterion. See here, 3 by 4.5 is equal to 6 by 4. Sorry, 4 by 6. 3 1.5 times, 4 1.5 times. The ratio is 1 by 1.5 is equal to 1 by 1.5. Or if I am taking 4.5 by 3, this is 1.5. 6 by 4, that is also 1.5. The angle formed by 3 cm and 4 cm is also 60. The angle formed by 4.5 by 60 also 60. So from here, I can observe BC and QR also in the same ratio. So this criterion is called SAS criterion. Side, angle, side. If two sides are in the same proportion, the angle formed by the two sides is also same in two triangle, then the two triangles we can call as the similar triangles. This criterion is called SAS criterion. Understand what is the meaning of SAS criterion? Proof I am going to do now. Is it clear what is the SAS criterion of similarity? Students, so we have to take the angle formed by these two sides only into consideration. Suppose if I am having, there is a side, another side, and this angle is same, then I can't consider here for SAS criterion. So how I to write my theorem here? The 8th theorem, this one. If one angle of a triangle, is equal to the one angle of another triangle, and the sides including the angle, angle are proportional. Then the two triangles are similar. Is it clear, guys, with respect to my previous slide and this statement? So this is a statement of the SAS criterion of similarity theorem. Is it clear, students?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now what I am doing is, what is the given data? There is a triangle ABC.
Counting.
And another triangle. I'm taking some other triangle. This triangle is ABC. This triangle is PQR or DEF. I'm taking to make it your textbook reference. So what is the given data here? One angle of the triangle is same. I'm taking angle A is equal to angle D. So given data. Given data is angle A is equal to angle D, and the sides contain angle A are, what are the sides contain angle A? AB and DE ratio will be equal to AC and DF ratio. This is, these two statements are given statements. What I have to prove? I have to prove triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. If I am able to prove BC by EF also equal to same thing, and angle A is equal to angle B, sorry, angle B is equal to angle E, angle C is equal to angle F, then I can say both are similar. That's what I have to prove. So to prove these two triangles are similar, so construction. So I'm cutting off, cut off DP on DE such that DP is equal to AB. I'm taking exactly AP length and I'm cutting from D. So this is P. And I'm taking exactly AC length and I'm cutting on AF, that is Q. And I'm joining this one. So my DP is exactly equal to AB. My DQ is exactly equal to AC. Like that, I'm marking the two points. Cut off DQ on DF such that DQ will be equal to AC. So this is the construction, and join PQ. Is it clear, guys? What is my construction? Now, proof. If you observe here, I can say triangle ABC will be congruent with triangle DPQ. Why? SAS axiom of congruency. SAS axiom of congruency. Am I right or wrong? How SAS congruency? SAS congruency says what? Side angle. So SAS congruency, how I can say here? From SAS congruency, AB is equal to DP and AC is equal to DQ and angle A is equal to angle D. One side, two sides are equal and the angle containing these two sides are same. That's the reason SAS congruency, these two triangles are incongruent. DPQ and ABC are congruent. If two triangles are congruent, I can say corresponding angles are equal. I can take angle P is equal to angle B. The reason is corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Angle P is equal to angle P. And given ratio, there is a ratio. From given, I can take AB by DE is equal to AC by DF. I am taking the construction AB in such a way, AB is equal to DP by DE and AC is equal to DQ by DF. So from the construction, AB is equal to DP, I'm marking the point AB is equal to DP, AC is equal to DQ. So far, is it clear, guys? What I'm doing? I'm relating, I'm trying to prove DPQ and DEF are similar. DPQ, PQ should be parallel to EF. That is what I am trying to prove. So from here, if DP by DE is equal to DQ by DF, from the converse of Thales theorem, I can say PQ is parallel to DE. PQ is parallel to BC, guys. I can say PQ is parallel to BC. So not BC, guys. DF. Is PQ is parallel to DF by the converse of Thales theorem. Converse of basic proportionality theorem. Am I right or wrong, guys? If PQ is parallel to DF, I can say angle P is equal to angle B. Angle B, this is a triangle. Sorry, guys. D, E, F, this is PQ. Angle P is equal to angle E. Angle Q is equal to angle F. Previously, already I proved angle P is equal to angle B. Angle Q can be written as angle C. So, from the congruence concept, this is CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. This is from the converse of BPT theorem. So, from these two statements, I can write angle A is equal to angle D, that is given. From these two statements, angle E is equal to angle B, angle F is equal to angle C. Angle F is equal to angle C. So from here, what I can write? I can say triangle. No need to mention this one also. Using AA criterion, triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF from AA criterion of similarity. So from here, triangle ABC and triangle DEF are similar if one side angle and side are, sorry, one angle is same in the two triangles and two sides are same in proportion. So this similarity is called, this is called SAS criterion of similarity. Hope you understood, guys. If any doubts, please let me know. Students, please. If anyone having any doubts, please let me know. Is it clear? How I see here also same thing. We are using the basic proportionality theorem and angle similarity with the help of those techniques. The first step is I am constructing and I am proving these two triangles are similar. DPQ and DEF are similar. And I am proving DPQ and ABC are congruent. After that, I am proving angle P is equal to angle B, angle Q is equal to angle F. But already I proved these two triangles are similar. Angle P is equal to angle B, angle C is equal to angle Q. From that, I am relating to angle C and angle F. So three steps. First, proving these two are similar, these two are congruent, and automatically DEF and ABC are similar to each other because of DPQ and ABC are congruent to each other. So this is one step. If you keep it in mind, you can able to prove everything. Hope you are clear, guys. Anyone having any doubts? Aditi, in this, Sanyu, please. Students, please. Shall I go for the next one? Ninth one?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So ninth one is little simple. It is little related to right angle triangles. Now onwards, most of the things we are going to discuss with right angle triangles. If there is a triangle like this, some triangle, and take any vertex, any angle A, B, C, and draw one altitude from that to opposite side. That is, I am taking an altitude from A to B, C. What he is saying is, this altitude is dividing the triangle into two parts. What are the two parts? If it is meeting at D, I am getting two triangles. This is triangle 1, ABD. This is triangle 2, ADC. So, if any line drawn, any perpendicular drawn from one vertex to opposite side, that altitude, that is called altitude. This altitude is dividing the triangle into two right angle triangles. They are trying to say these two right angle triangles are similar to each other. Understand what I am saying, guys? These two right angle triangles are similar to each other. Got it? What I am saying? How to construct the statement? Students, is it clear what is our next one? If a perpendicular drawn from the vertex of the right angle, the vertex of the right angle, the vertex of the right angle of a right triangle to the hypotenuse. Sorry guys, I missed. This is a right angle. Angle A is right angle always. So, right angle of a vertex of the right angle of a right triangle to the hypotenuse. Right triangle means right angle triangle. Right triangle to the hypotenuse. Then the triangle on each side of the altitude. Then the triangle on each side of the altitude. Each side of the altitude. Or similar to the whole triangle, similar to the whole triangle and also each other, and also each other. This is the statement of this theorem, the ninth theorem. Suppose if I am taking a right angle triangle, or you can visualize this diagram like this also. This is a right angle triangle where right angle at A, I am taking a perpendicular from A. And this is also another two right angle triangles meeting at D. He is saying triangle ABC is similar to triangle ABD. And triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADC, ABD. This is ABD. And also similar to each other. ABD is similar to triangle ADC. These are the three statements we have to prove. Automatically, if I am able to prove these two statements, triangle ABC is similar to ABD, ABC is similar to ADC, automatically these two also similar. So, this I have to prove. What is the given data? ABC is the right angle triangle. That is only the given data. And AD is perpendicular to BC. So, I am going to the proof for this line. Proof. So, this is my triangle. I am taking the right angle triangle in this direction to understand the remaining two triangles. This whole angle is 90. Triangle ABC, the whole angle is 90. And it is meeting at BAC is 90 degrees. If it is AD is the perpendicular. So it is forming two more right angle triangles. ABD is one right angle. ADC is another right angle. Now, what is the given data? Given data is triangle ABC is right triangle. Angle A is equal to 90 degrees. AD is perpendicular to BC. What I have to prove? I have to prove the altitude is dividing the triangle into two parts. The two triangles are similar to each other and similar to the main triangle. The first one is triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADB. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADC. Third one, triangle ADC similar to triangle ADB. Is it clear, guys? What I have to prove? Is it clear? Instead of writing always ABD triangle, angle ABD, angle DAB, I am marking the triangle numbers, angle numbers. This angle I am taking 1, this angle I am taking 3, this angle taking 4, and this angle I am taking 2. You know angle 1 plus angle 2 is 90 degrees because angle 4 plus angle 3 is 90. So that we can discuss. So how I am going to prove? I done, instead of writing BAD, I can mention with angle 1. Angle 1 mentions angle BAD. Angle 1 is representing angle BAD. So mark the angles and shown in figure. Mark the angles as shown. So I am marking the angles. Four angles I marked. At angle D, there are two right angles. That's why I am not going to mark it. So in triangle DBA or ABD or ADB and triangle ABC, the main triangle, angle ADB is equal to 90 degrees, angle BAC is equal to 90 degrees because it is given. DB is right angle, that's the reason it is making at 90 degrees at this point. BAC is angle 4 plus angle 3 from the main triangle. It is a right angle triangle at A. So this is given. This is given. And this is AD is perpendicular to BC. That's the reason angle ADB is 90 degrees. So instead of writing this, I can say from the diagram, each angle is 90 degrees. From the diagram, I can write like this. Angle ADB is equal to angle BAC, each 90 degrees angle. Because second statement is any other angle I can prove. See here, if I am taking DBA, how the DBA looks, this is the DBA triangle. A, D, B. How the ABC looks, this is ABC. A, B, C. So this is common angle for both the triangles. I can write angle ABD is equal to angle ABC, same angle. If two angles of a triangle are same, from the angle-angle criteria, I can say both the triangles are similar to each other. Students, got it what I am saying? So, what I can write? Since triangle ADB is similar to triangle ABC from angle-angle criterion of similarity. Is it simple? Students, from angle criterion of similarity, is it? Now, the same way I'm going to prove the main triangle for second. What is the second? I have to take other triangle. This is A, B, C. A, B, C. From triangle ADC and triangle ABC, angle ADC is equal to angle BAC, both are 90 degrees, both are right angles, and angle ACD is equal to angle ACB, same angle. So from here I can say triangle ADC is similar to triangle ABC, same AA criterion of similarity. Guys, is it clear? First two statements have I proved? It's actually very simple. Am I right or wrong? What is the next statement? Two small triangles should be similar. How I am going to prove these two small triangles are similar? Let's see. What are the third statement? I have to prove the altitude is dividing into two triangles. This is one triangle A, D, B. This is 90. This is angle 1. This is angle 4, I marked. This is another triangle splitted due to the altitude A, D, C. This is 90. This is angle 2 and this is angle 3. Now, I am taking these two triangles. Angle 1 plus angle 4 is equal to 90. The reason is, from triangle ABC, angle BAC is 90 degrees. So angle A is splitting because of the altitude into two angles, but actually it is right angle. So angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 90 degrees. No, this is not. This is angle 3 plus angle 4. Now I am going to do this one. Angle 1 plus angle 4 is equal to 90 degrees. Why? How I can write angle 1 plus angle 4 is 90 degrees? From triangle ADB, angle 1 plus angle 4 plus 90 degrees is equal to 180. From this I can write angle 1 plus angle 4 is 90 degrees. Same as angle 3 plus angle 2 is also 90 degrees. Angle 3 plus angle 2 is also 90 degrees. Or this two statement is enough to prove angle 1 plus angle 4 is equal to 90. Angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 90. 4, 4 cancel. I can say angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Angle 1 is equal to angle 3. So, how I can write? Angle 1 is equal to angle 3. From above. And angle ADB is equal to angle ADC, both are 90 degrees. So two angles are same in two different triangles. Here angle B is equal to angle D and angle B is equal to angle 3. That is angle 1 is equal to angle 3. So I can say triangle ADB is similar to triangle ADC from angle by angle criterion of similarity. Is it clear, guys? How I code angle-angle criterion here? Friends, is it clear? Three. I'm writing the two triangles each and every time separately. Then it will be easy to prove. But it is not mandatory to draw. Only for your understanding purpose, you can draw and you can able to prove. This is first proof. This is second proof. This is the third one. Next time, whenever you are getting a question in a right angle triangle, altitude drawn from the right angle to the hypotenuse will use the two similar triangles. So all the three triangles are similar to each other. Shall I go for some numericals based on these theorems? So what are the theorems we left, guys? How many theorems we left? We done up to 9. So shall we go back and check what are the theorems left for us? I think area related to triangle, similar triangles is left for us. Yeah, look into this basic proportionality theorem, and we done if a line divides the two sides are in the same ratio, line parallel to second side, converse of basic proportionality theorem, corresponding angles are equal, their corresponding sides are proportional and their similar triangles. This is angle criteria. Corresponding sides of two triangles, their corresponding angles are equal. I think this is SSS criteria. Am I right, guys? One angle of a triangle is equal to one angle of another triangle, and the sides including these triangles are proportional. This is SAS criteria. The perpendicular is drawn. This is the ninth theorem as ninth theorem we discussed. So three more theorems. So the ratio of the areas and Pythagoras theorem. These two things is remaining. These two triangles is related to Pythagoras theorem. This is the areas. So in next class, we are going to discuss these three theorems. It's the end of the triangles concept. So today class, we are going to discuss overall based on this theorem sum. So what are the theorems? SAS, angle, and SSS, and right angle. These four theorems, based on these four theorems, we are going to discuss some numericals. Guys, shall we go for some numericals? Students, shall I go for some numericals? Yes, please. Somebody is trying to talk something, please. Durlav, Harita, Pooja, please. Yeah. So I'm going to give one question. In the figure given below, all the distances are measured in centimeter. All the distances are measured in centimeters. Find angle P. This is very simple. Just from the concept of similarity of two triangles, you can proceed. This is angle ABC. This angle is 80 degrees. And this is 3.8. And this is 3 root 3. And this is 6. And another triangle is there. PQR. This is 6 root 3 and this is 7.6 and this is 12 and he is asking what is this angle. and one more data is given. This is 60 degrees. From this, what is this angle, guys? What is the remaining angle of ABC? What is the remaining angle of ABC? Angle A plus angle B plus angle C. Not required. Anyway, we need angle P. Let's see whether it is required or not. We can see later. Angle sum property. First, I have to verify these two triangles are similar. If it is similar, what are the corresponding sides? It's very clear. BC 2 times 12. 3 root 3 2 times 6 root 3. 3.8 12 times 7.6. So I can take PQ by BC is equal to 12 by 6, that is equal to 2. If I am taking QR by AB, 7.6 by 3.8, that is 2. If I am taking PR by AC, PR is 6 root 3, AC is 3 root 3. P3 cancel, this is 2. So PQ by BC, QR by AB and PR by AC is equal to 2. Then I can say the corresponding sides are in the same proportion. Triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Not PQR. How I can write this one? Triangle ABC and triangle PQR are similar. Which criterion, guys? Haritha, Durlok, which criterion here? SSS criterion. The corresponding sides. What are the corresponding sides here? PQ is corresponding to BC. This ratio is equal to QR to AB and PR to AC. So from this, what are the corresponding angles? The PQ opposite is R. So BC opposite is A. Angle A is equal to angle R here. And angle B is equal to angle Q here. Angle C is equal to angle B. These are the corresponding angles are same from the SSS criterion. Because if two triangles are similar, corresponding angles are also same. But identifying the corresponding angles is important. See, this is 6 centimeter, this is 4 centimeter. So angle A is equal to angle R. B is opposite to 3 root 3. So here Q is opposite to 6 root 3. Angle Q is equal to angle B. So angle P is equal to angle C. So how to calculate the angle P? Angle sum property. Angle P is equal to angle C, that is equal to 180 minus angle A plus angle B. This is equal to 180 minus of 60 plus 80. And this is 180 minus 140. So this will be 40 degrees. So angle P is equal to 40 degrees. This is how we can able to calculate with the help of the theorems. But if it is MCQs, no need to do this process. Just you can take in rougher, identify corresponding sides. How to make it corresponding sides, even in using mind calculation, you can say 6, 12, 3 root 3, 6 root 3, 3.8, 7.6 are in proportion. So the angle opposite to the three lines is C. Here angle opposite to the three lines is P. So from here C is how much? 40 degrees. So 7.6 opposite is P. This is 40 degrees. Like that you can do in if it is MCQ. No need to solve the entire thing. No need to show this procedure. Is it clear, guys? How to do for one mark the same question? Students, please. Is it clear? Vaishnavi? Harita, guys, please respond. Yeah. One more question based on this. This is 70 degrees. This is 125 degrees. This point of intersection is O. This is DC. And this is AB. My question is, in the adjoint figure, the question is, in the adjoint figure, adjoining figure, triangle ODC is similar to triangle OAB. Angle BOC is equal to 125 degrees and angle CDO is equal to 70 degrees. Find first question, angle DOC. Second one is angle DCO. Third one is angle OAB. How to do this question, guys? I gave these two triangles are similar. First triangle, second triangle are similar right away. So it is your duty how to find the corresponding angles are here. I didn't mention the rays are parallel to each other. AB and CD are not parallel or parallel. I didn't see. But I said ODC is similar to OAB and I gave the some angles. How to do this question, guys? You can understand one thing here. If it is a straight line, then sort like this. If DOB is a straight line, I can take straight angle. Angle DOC plus angle COB is equal to 180. So from that angle, DOC plus 125 degrees is equal to 180. So from here, I am getting the angle DOC. Angle DOC is equal to 180 minus 125. So 180 minus 125 is 55. So from vertically opposite angles, I can write this is 55 degrees and this is 55 degrees. Is it clear, guys? How I got angle DOC is 55 degrees and angle AOB is also 55 degrees. So from angle sum property, can I calculate angle OCD? What is angle OCD, guys? Anyone? For second question, to calculate. This is the triangle I am taking. D, C, O. This is 55 and this is 70 given. So angle DOC plus angle ODC plus angle DCO is equal to 180 degrees. So this is 55 plus 70 plus angle DCO is equal to 180 degrees. So what is the remaining angle? What is the DCO angle then? So angle DCO is equal to 180 minus 70 plus 55. How much you'll get, guys? 55 degrees. So angle DCO is also 55 degrees. This is also 55 degrees. So how to calculate angle OAB, I want this angle. How to calculate angle OAB? How to calculate angle OAB? It's very simple. For third question, I am using the similarity concept here. We know as triangle ODC is similar to triangle OBA. How it is? OE is the common angle, and D already I found. Angle D is 70 degrees. Corresponding to angle B, angle A is corresponding to angle C. C is corresponding to angle A. So from here, angle A is equal to angle C. That is, angle OAB is equal to 55 degrees. This is how we can able to solve this one. Is it clear, guys? Shall I go for one more question? The last question for today. Tomorrow we are going to wind up remaining three theorems, and we will go for some more numericals for day after tomorrow class. Is it clear, students? Shall I go for one more question? Akshita, Amruta, Arman, Durlav, please. Harita, yeah. So you have to try this question. The given two triangles are similar to each other. Triangle ABC. This is 2x minus 1. This is 3x. This is 2x plus 2. And triangle DFE. How it is similar? The similar is, triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. That is, angle A is equal to angle D, angle B is equal to angle E, angle C is equal to angle F. From this, you can understand what is the corresponding angles. So this is 6x, this is 18, and this will be 3x plus 9. If these two triangles are similar to each other in this way, find the length of all the sides of the two triangles. Find the lengths of sides of the triangle, sides of the two triangles. Please, guys, proceed. How to solve this question? Guys, anyone got the answer? What is the x value you got? Anyone got the x value? So we can mark the similar angles. A is similar to, A is corresponding to D, B is corresponding to F, B is corresponding to E, B is corresponding to E, and C is corresponding to F. This is the logic in this question. If you take straight away 2x minus 1, 6x, I don't know whether it is right or wrong. So first you write the corresponding sides. AB is corresponding to the ratio of AB. AB is opposite to angle C. So it is corresponding to DE. It is not corresponding to DF. And BC is corresponding to angle D. Hence it is FE or EF. And AC is corresponding to, AC is opposite to angle B. Angle B is corresponding to angle E. Angle E opposite is 6X. That is DF. Or FB. So now you apply your equations. AB is 2x minus 1, DE is 18. 3x divided by 6x will be equal to CA is BC is 3x, EF is 3x plus 9. Sorry guys. EF is 3x plus 9. AC is, this is also wrong. This is 2x plus 2. AC is 3x and FD is 6x. I'm taking these two ratios, I'm solving these two ratios, I'm solving, then I will get the x value. You take any one ratio and you can solve. I'm taking 2x minus 1 by 18 is equal to 3x by 6x and xx cancel 3 2 times, 2 9 times. 2x minus 1 is equal to 9, 2x is equal to 10, so I got x is equal to 5. So if I got x is equal to 5, then I can able to calculate everything. So AB is equal to 2x minus 1, that is equal to 9. BC is equal to 2x plus 2, that is equal to 12. And AC is equal to 3x, that is equal to 15. Same as from the triangle DEF, DF is equal to 6x, that is equal to 30. FE is equal to 3x plus 9, that is equal to 24. And DE is equal to 18 given. Now you are taking the ratio also, you will get 9 by 18. 12 by 24, 15 by 30. So all are corresponding to each other. So this is how we can apply the similarity concept to any given situation. So tomorrow class, we are going to do a few theorems. Three more theorems are left. One is related to areas. The ratio of area of two similar triangles is equal to the ratio of the squares of the corresponding sides. So connecting the area of the similar triangles to corresponding sides of the similar triangles. Another one is triangle. In the Pythagoras theorem, triangle, the square of one side. The last one is converse of the Pythagoras theorem, I can say. Converse of the Pythagoras theorem. So these are the three theorems left. After these theorems, we can sit more on numericals. Is it clear, guys? Anyone having any doubts, please let me know. Otherwise, we can leave. We can wind up the session. Anyone having any doubts? Akshita, Arman, please. Students?
No doubts.
We'll meet in the next class, guys. But please go through the theorems again and again. Then it will be easy. Any kind of questions you can do. Bye, everyone.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.